Thoracic imaging refers to the radiographic assessment of the chest and thoracic region. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of the topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, thoracic imaging is the radiographic process of creating a visual representation of the thorax for medical intervention. The primary types include a chest radiograph, computed tomography, ventilation perfusion scan, and positron emission tomography. Each type of thoracic imaging helps the medical professional learn more about the state of the patient's condition. So now let's talk briefly about each type. First, we have the chest radiograph, or just simply known as a chest X-ray. It's a radiographic imaging technique used for the assessment of the heart, lungs, and structures within the thoracic cavity. It occurs as an X-ray passes through the chest to a film, which provides a visual representation of the structures within this cavity. The appearance of the X-ray depends on the densities of the structures within the chest. This includes air, fat, soft tissue, bone, and fluid. Lungs that are filled with air have a black appearance on the chest X-ray, which is known as being radiolucent. With that said, bones and fluid typically absorb more of the X-ray beams during the process and display more white on the chest X-ray, which is known as being radiopaque. Next, we have computed tomography, also known as a CT scan. It's a radiographic imaging technique that generates cross-sectional images of an organ or tissue structure. It's performed in radiology by medical professionals in order to obtain detailed images of the body that can be used for diagnostic purposes. Simply put, it's a quick, painless, and non-invasive method to generate cross-sectional images that can be analyzed by physicians to get an idea of what's going on with the patient. Next up is the ventilation perfusion scan, or VQ scan for short. It's an imaging test that uses a radiographic substance to assess the ventilation and perfusion of the lungs. By measuring the flow of air and blood within the lungs, it allows for the diagnosis of various diseases. However, a VQ scan is typically indicated to help diagnose or rule out a pulmonary embolism. It can also help physicians examine the lungs of preoperative patients. And finally, we have positron emission tomography, or PET scan for short. It's an imaging technique that also uses radioactive substances to examine the metabolic activity of various parts of the body. Radio tracers are injected or ingested into the body and help produce gamma rays. These rays help provide a three-dimensional visual of the target area. In respiratory care, a PET scan is typically recommended for the diagnosis or evaluation of lung cancer. But again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We've talked more about each type of thoracic imaging in separate videos here on our channel. But just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. But real quick, if you don't mind, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And you might as well go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. Hopefully what you learned in this video was useful and can help you develop a better understanding of this topic. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to dive even deeper, we do have a full guide on our website. I will drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.